ano, no? Yung family, you know? Can you kindly paki ano po sa amin, paki kwento ang nangyari? Sa sinasabi nila that it was a bypass operation, and according to your narration to Deputy Speaker and to us, it was not. So you have the floor. Ito yung pagkakataon nyo.
Magandang hapon po. Bali po, ako po yung kapatid ng binaril po nilang si Brian. Mga 6:20, 6, basta po humigit ko mulang ng alas 6, nabaril po yung kapatid ko. At nalaman ko pong 7 o'clock, dinala sa ospital, at 7 o'clock din sila nag-conduct ng operation po. 6:25 po, baril na po ang kapatid ko. Pero hindi po nila agad dinala sa ospital. Namatay po ang kapatid ko, naubusan po ng dugo. Saan po nila dinala? Napakasakit po, kitang-kita ko po nung binaril. Wala pong kalaban-laban, wala po ako nakitang drug. Na sinasabi nilang drug bypass operation po, wala po. Nang laban, wala pong baril. Nakasakay po ang kapatid ko sa motor. Pagbaba po ng sakay ng kotseng green, dalawa, binaril po nung isa. Wala pong kalaban-laban.
Mr. Chair, if I may.
Sige, Congressman Busita.
Mr. Laresma, mga gaano kalayo ka doon sa pinangyarihan? More or less, ilang meters?
Mga ito lang po, tsaka yung
dulo. Okay. Colonel Litag, Mr. Chun, nandiyan ba si ano? Police Master Sergeant Makaraig?
Dito po, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, pwede ba kay Mr. Police Master Sergeant Makaraig? Nandiyan ba?
Yes, andiyan. Sige, you can ask question, Congressman Busita.
Ilan yung operatives doon sa insidente na yon?
Bali po ay 5, Your Honor.
5. Sa out of 5 members, operatives, may kasama ba kayong policewoman? Wala.
Meron po, Your Honor.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Laresma, sinabi mo na binaril yung kapatid mo.
Opo.
At sinasabi mo sa committee na to na malapit ka lang. Tama?
Opo, malapit po ako.
Doon ba sa nakita mo, ano ang bumaril? Lalaking pulis o babaeng pulis?
Sa pagkakalap ko po, tumboy po siya.
So, babae?
Babae po.
Mr. Chair, nandiyan po ba si Police Staff Sergeant Michi Perez, yung nag-act as poster buyer?
Your Honor, andito po. PSSG Michi Perez, Your Honor.
Pwede ka bang tumayo, Police Staff Sergeant Michi Perez? Mr. Laresma, sabi mo, babae yung bumaril sa kapatid mo.
Opo.
At base sa team leader, isa lang yung kasama.
Opo.
Yan bang policewoman na yan ang sinasabi mo?
Siya po, siguradong sigurado po ako.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Chair. You may take your seat, Police Staff Sergeant Michi Perez. Michi Perez, base doon sa report na nakarating sa Regional Director ng Police Regional Office 4A, General Lucas, ikaw ang nag-act as poster buyer, tama?
Yes po, Your Honor.
Nagkaroon ba ng bentahan? Wala.
May bentahan po, Your Honor.
So, nakabili ka?
Yes, Your Honor.
Nandito rin sa report na nakita mo, allegedly, na may firearm.
Nakabukol.
Itong nasawi, tama?
Yes, Your Honor.
Paano mo nasabing may sidearm siya? Paano?
Sir, nakabukol po dito sa may bandang harap na kaliwa nung bewang niya, sir.
Bandang kaliwa, may nakabukol. So, nung makita mong may nakabukol sa gawing kaliwa niya, anong ginawa mo?
Sir, nag-iingat na po ako, sir. Medyo baka, sir, firearm, sir, yun eh.
Anong nakita mong, anong ginawa mong pag-iingat?
Sir, standstill lang ako kasi, sir, baka makahalata na intel operative ako. Baka putukan agad ako, sir.
Sabi mo, baka makahalata. Pero sabi dito sa report sa regional director, nakahalata yung biktima. Ano ba ang totoo? Nakahalata o baka mahalata?
Sir, doon sa report po, Your Honor, nakahalata yung si Brian Laresma, sir.
O, sige.
Nung bumaba, sir, yung mga kasamahan ko na operatiba, sir.
Okay.
So, clarification na, lang, ano, Congressman. Maputo lang kita kasi medyo naligaw ako doon. May if you will allow me, ano.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Lang. Yung bang pangyayaring yun, RD, saan ba nangyari yung incident nung barilan?
According po sa report is sa may boundary ng San Juan and Chaong, Your Honor.
So sa tulay, di ba may bridge doon? Yung boundary?
Yes, Your Honor.
So sa bridge nangyari yung barilan?
Yes, Your Honor. Sa may tulay po.
So kung sa bridge nangyari yung barilan, so yun ang inoperate nyo, ano? Sino to? Si Michi Perez. So doon talaga yung tagpuan ninyo?
Yes, Your Honor.
So nung nandun na kayo sa area, ilan sasakyan ang nakatigil doon sa bridge?
Bale, sir, yung sinasakyan ko pong motor at saka, sir, yung naka-position namin na nakasasakyan na four-wheel, sir, yung Bios sa green. Bale, sir, dalawa yung sasakyan. Pero magkalayo, sir, sila nung ano.
So, katext mo si, ano, si Laresma?
No, Your Honor. Ang...
Paano ka nag-po sa kanya, nabibili ka?
Your Honor, ba,
paano mo siya na-contact?
Humigit ko mo lang, Your Honor, 640 ng...
Hindi, tinatanong kita, paano mo na-contact si, ano? Paano mo siya nagsabi, paano mo nasabi na, oh, magkita tayo dito sa tulay kasi bibili ako ng, ano, ng droga?
Your Honor, yung confidential asset po yung kausap niya, balik...
Hindi, paano nga kayo magkikita doon? Paano mo siya na-contact? Kasi posure ka, di ba? Yes. So, siyempre, may contact ka doon para sabihin na, oh, sige, magkita tayo dito, bibili ako. Parang ganun, di ba? O paano mo siya na-contact?
Sir, ito, yung confidential asset po namin, yung alpha namin po, yung kausap niya. Bali, sir, nung kausap niya, ibinigay na, sir, niya yung description ko, sir. Yung suot ko. And then, kasi sabi niya, nung ni Brian, na pupunta na siya doon sa Mr. area.
Chair. Yes, oh, Congressman, na ako, please.
Sa dami na nang inimbestigaan natin na illegal by bus, may participation palagi ng confidential agent. At yung confidential agent na yun, yun na nagtuturo doon sa subject na bypass operation. May ask, Mr. Chair, pwede ko bang tanungin yung si Madam Michi? Sino po yung confidential agent po ninyo?
Sir, confidential po yun, sir.
Paano ko po malalaman, Madam Michi, na nagsasabi ka ng totoo?
Sir,
that's a very good excuse yung sinasabi niyo. Now, matanong kita, alam mo ba kung yung confidential agent ninyo ay official confidential agent ng PNP? Huwag mo akong papasukin doon at baka ikaw ang maiipit.
Sorry, Your Honor.
Yung confidential agent mo dyan, official na confidential agent ng PNP? O agent nyo lang?
Sir, ano po siya, BIN, sir?
Sagutin mo ako. Hindi mo sinasagot yung tanong ko.
Official po, sir.
Ano?
Official po, sir.
Official. Nakalista sa official agent ng PNP. Baka hindi mo alam ang ibig sabihin nung nakalista sa official agent ng PNP. I do not know kung na-assign ka na sa intelligence unit ng Philippine National Police. Ngayon, sagutin mo ako. Meron ba siyang appointment na confidential agent ninyo? O house show na agent lang ninyo?
Sir, meron talaga sir appointment, sir.
Mr. Chair, may I request whoever is in possession of that authority that he or she is a confidential agent be submitted to this committee?
Yes, we'll be
because if she is found lying, kagaya ni Honorable Paduano, papakuha site in contempt ko rin siya.
Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Yeah, Michi, with the indulgence of Congressman Basita, I'm sorry, you know, very crucial lang itong i-discuss natin. Michi Perez, may we remind you, again, lagi namin sinasabi ito, binibigyan namin ng pagkakataon. Huwag ka magsisinungaling dito talaga. So, ang sinasabi mo, may nag-text sa kanya kaya pumunta si si Brian Laresma doon sa Tulay para magpalitan, di ba, ng pagbili ng drug at yung pera, di ba? Bibigyan ka namin ng pagkakataon na yung confidential agent mo, ano sinasabi mo, confidential informant mo, na umattend sa susunod na hearing namin. Okay? And inform us of those communication or texts that transpired between Brian and that informant. No? Because right now, no, I heard, and this brother of the victim will be submitting to us right now. Sasabit sa amin yung kanilang texts na doon sila magkikita ng kapatid niya at doon niya ibibigay yung pera ng pambili noong tinatawag na solar fund. Do you have the copy of that text between you and your brother?
Meron po.
Yes. So, Michi, if I see this communication between him and his brother, na doon sila magkikita, sa tuloy na yon, at hindi mo maipadadala sa amin yung informant mo na nagsasabi na si Brian at yung iyong informant ay magkikita doon, sa tuloy na yon, then we will be citing you in contempt. Now we will give you a chance, Michi, ha? Ibigay mo sa amin right now kung sino informant mo, and then we will be asking him or her to be in here. And you, Mr. Laresma, kindly submit to us yung dokumento na nagte-text ikaw at ang brother mo. Okay. Congressman Busita, now you have the floor.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Sergeant Perez, Mr. Chair, noong makita mo na sabi mo may nakabukol sa kaliwang baywang, ano yung ginawa mo? Sergeant Perez, Mr. Chair,
Mr. Honor,
noong makita mo, sinabi mo may nakabukol sa kaliwang baywang, anong ginawa mo?
Sir, tinuloy ko lang po yung transaction, sir.
Tinuloy mo? So, nagkabentahan?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. After na magkabentahan, anong sumunod na pangyayari?
Sir, yung sa nag-pre-arrange, pagkaabot ko, sir, nung basura, sir, nag-pre-arrange signal na, sir, ako.
Okay. Doon sa report, lumalabas may tatlong putok eh. At ngayon, sinasabi na Mr. Laresma, ikaw ang bumaril doon sa kapatid niya. Now, doon sa tatlong putok, may pinutok ka ba o wala?
Meron, sir. Isa, sir.
Isa. Sinong unang pumutok?
Si Brian Laresma, sir.
Ano ang gamit niyang baril?
Caliber 38 po, sir.
Anong distance mo kay Mr. Laresma doon sa namatay?
More or less, sir, 5 meters.
5 meters. So, kung sinasabi mong 5 meters, familiar ka ba sa 5 meters? Pwede ba, Mr. Chair, tumayo si Sergeant Perez? Gaano kalayo yung 5 meters? Diyan sa harap mo, ituro mo. Sige, gaano kalayo?
So, sir, nakakaya lang, sir.
Alin dyan?
So, sir, na lamesa sa kasunod.
yung edge ng table?
5 meters. Yes, sir.
Yung edge ng table?
Ito, sir, table to na. Yung tapat ko, sir, at saka yun, sir.
Gusto mo bang, so yung kung tatlo yung putok doon sa report, isa sa'yo, kanino yung dalawang putok?
Kay Brian po, sir.
May anting ka ba? Opo ka lang. 5 meters, hindi ka tinamaan. Tama ba? Tama?
Yes, sir.
So, nung nakaputok siya ng dalawa, saka mo siya pinutukan, tama?
Yes, sir.
Parang hindi ka panipaniwala yun eh. Kasi nakadalawang putok muna siya bago ka pumutok, Mr. Chair. Anong height ni Mr. Laresma, yung namatay?
More or less, sir, 5'6", sir.
5'6", more or less. Bakit ang tama sa paa? Anong sir, intention mo?
Sir, i-disable, sir. At saka, sir, yung nasa, na, napiligtan na, sir, ako na paputokan, sir, si Laresma ng issued firearm ko dahil nasa panganib na, sir, yung buhay ko at saka yung buhay ng kasamahan ko, sir.
Kaya mo pinutukan sa paa?
Yes, sir, para ma-disable lang.
So, after na maputukan siya sa paa, anong ginawa ng operatiba?
Sir, dinala, sir, sa ospital, sir.
Dinala sa ospital. Mr. Chair, RD, by the way, Mr. Chair, RD, mayroong autopsy report na po ba?
Positive po, Your Honor.
Ano daw po ang cause of death ng ano?
Autopsy, autopsy. Sa medical legal. Cause of death. The cause of death was due to a gunshot wound to the lower extremity, Your Honor.
Okay. Sergeant Makaraig, Mr. Chair.
Yes, sir.
Totoo ba yung report na yung BIOS green, walang plaka?
Yes, Your Honor.
Ganon din yung motorsiklo?
Yes, Your Honor.
Kanino yung BIOS na kotse?
Service po naming mga intel, Your Honor.
Okay, service. Pero kanino nakarehistro yon?
Bali po, isa paggamit po ng LGU.
So, sa local government unit?
Yes, Your.
Tanong, bakit walang plaka?
Tinanggal po namin sa dyan, Your Honor, dahil sa dami na po ng aming nahuli ay kilala na po yung sasakyan namin ng karamihang mga adik, Your Honor.
Yung motorsiklo na walang plaka, kanino yon?
Doon po sa inuulit ni PSG Perez na Alpha niya.
Okay, Alpha. RD, Mr. Chair, tama ba na pag nag-operate walang plaka?
No, Your Honor.
Okay. RD, hindi naman po kayo mag-general kung hindi kayo dumaan sa lahat ng mga assignments like operation, intelligence, admin functions. Sa inyo po bang investigation, RD, is it armed encounter or not?
Based on the result of the investigation, dito sa report po nila, it's an armed encounter, but the investigation shows otherwise, Your Honor. That's why nga po, nakapag-file tayo ng murder case sa Lucena, and nagkaroon po tayo ng pre-charge sa investigation sa admin naman, Your Honor.
So, yun lamang po, Mr. Chair. Okay, by the way, balikan ko lang para malinaw, no? Kasi, para malinaw, no? Naintindihan ko naman yung sagot mo, RD. Eh, baka naman din naintindihan ng ating mga kababayan para malaman nila yung tama at maling trabaho ng pulis. Arm encounter ba yung insidente o hindi po?
Based po sa investigation, wala pong arm encounter, kaya nga po nakapag-file tayo ng murder case laban dun sa limang police, Your Honor, and nagkaroon po tayo ng pre-charge investigation being conducted by PS, Your Honor.
Yun ang maganda sa iyo, RD. Hindi ka konsentidor. Yun ang gusto po nating madinig. Madinig na ating mga kababayan na hindi ka bias. So may kaso na, murder case, itong mga operatiba. Tama po ba, RD?
It was submitted, Your Honor, sa Piskalya yesterday, Your Honor.
So doon sa mga ibang pulis na nakikinig ngayon, huwag ninyong isacrifice yung karir ninyo, huwag ninyong isacrifice ang future ninyo, huwag ninyong isacrifice ang future ng pamilya ninyo. Gawin nyo yung tama. Yung nakasanayan yung mali, talikuran na ninyo. Kasi po dito sa Kongreso, particular dito sa Committee on Public Order and Safety, hindi kayo lulusot. Marami nang na-dismiss. Marami nang nakulong. Pag hindi kayo nagbago, sunod-sunod kayo. Si General Acop, ako, pareho kaming retired police. Mahal natin yung PNP. Pero kailangan natin, mas mahalin natin yung ating mga kababayan, public service. Yun lamang, Mr. Chair. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you so much, Congressman Bosita. Before I recognize Congressman Acop, and that's the very reason why we continue Resolution Number 776. Dahil itong Resolution 776, ano lang to eh, Region 4A lang to eh. And prior to this, we have already a motion that was moved by Congressman Erwin Tulfo to extend, di ba, yung sa ibang region. Kasi mukhang napapansin namin na ginagamit talaga ang bypass operation to conduct criminal activities. And this committee will never, never allow such thing to happen. Kaya ito nga, babala to sa ating mga kapulisan, no? Ito naman eh, kakaunti lang naman itong mga bad eggs. As always, sinasabi namin, hindi naman ito lahat. Ang problema na naapektuhan ng organisasyon, naapektuhan si General Lucas, because maraming mga pasaway doon sa region namin, which started when the good congressman from Antipolo started to investigate a case against a certain Major Porcincula, which now is already dismissed from the service and have a criminal case against him. So, hindi namin kayo titigilan to mga bad eggs, please. And to all the people, ano, mga ating mga kababayan na may ganitong klase ng problema, huwag po kayo matakot. Kami, hindi kami natatakot dito. And I'm very thankful do sa mga people like you na nire-reveal yung mga ganitong klase ng insidente for us to validate. Pero we are warning those who are just acting, no? Na iniisip nyo na mapapalusutan nyo kami dito. No, we will never allow that this committee will be used for that purpose. Ang sa amin, kung biktima kayo, ipagtatanggol namin. Pero kung kayo gagamitin nyo ang committee ito, then may kalalagyan din kayo. Pakukulong din namin kayo dito kung nagsisinungaling kayo. Congressman Acop, now you are recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Magandang hapon po sa atin lahat. May ask the RG. Oh, did I hear it correct na kayo po ay nag-iimbestiga doon sa mga participants sa operation na ito?
Yes, Your Honor.
Meno, ano po ang dahilan ninyo? Bakit nyo pinaimbestigahan po sila?
Your Honor, the suspect turned victim may namatay po, Your Honor.
Is it standard operating procedure of the Philippine National Police pag yung biktima ay namatay? Pag sa bypass operation, nagko-conduct kayo ng investigation?
On the part of IAS, Your Honor, motu proprio po, pag police po ang involved. And as the regional director, it is my obligation, Your Honor, to know the truth surrounding the incident, Your Honor. So I immediately directed the provincial director of Batangas to conduct an investigation, Your Honor.
Tapos na po ba yung investigation? Provincial director na Batangas?
Your Honor, the provincial director is with me. Baka pwede pong siya po yung sumagot, Your Honor.
Bago siya sumagot, Ardi, sa mga statements mo, parang duda ka rin sa report ng iyong mga opisyal na nag-participate sa operation na ito. Is my intuition correct?
In all the bypass operation na meron pong reported arm encounter, nagpapakandak po kagad ako ng investigation, Your Honor. Hindi lang po ito, but others, Your Honor.
Thank you. May I know the answer of the Provincial Director of Batangas?
Sir, magandang hapon po at sa members ng committee ito.
Go ahead.
Sir, based on the instruction of the Regional Director to conduct parallel investigation in collaboration with PS, sir. Briefly, sir, these are the our findings, no? Number one, sir, there were clear violations of the PNP manual in the conduct of anti-illegal drug operations. The IR, or dating tinatawag natin summary of information, were incomplete kasi ang nakasulat po dun, sir, ay alias Balot, Laresma. There was no proper validation conducted, hence no submission of surveillance report, developmental report. That would trigger the conduct of the appropriate bypass operation. So those prerequisite in the planning stage, sir, ay hindi po na-comply. Also, sir, the approved pre-operation clearance coming from the PDEA was approved around 7 in the evening, 7:15, and they jump open their station at around 6:45. So the operation was conducted without, hindi pa natanggap yung clearance coming from PDEA, which is required by regulation, sir.
In other words, nag-jump off sila, nagsimula na sila ng operation without the PDEA clearance.
Yes, sir.
Okay, please proceed.
Yes, sir. And also, sir, when we went over the documents submitted, particularly on the inventory of evidence seized in said operation, there was non-inclusion of the non-drug evidence like the caliber 38 allegedly used by the suspect or victim, Brian Laresma. So that is very critical because it was alleged that there was an armed encounter. Hence, in the document submitted, it was not included as part of the evidence. And also, sir, non-coordination with the local police unit. As a considering that this is a planned operation, at alam naman nila, sir, na yung lugar na pinangyarihan ay Candelaria, Quezon. It was Chaong Quezon, sir, I should say. Chaong Quezon, the reports, based on the reports, the incident happened in the territory of San Juan, Batangas. Hence, with that, sir, no, in summary, in coordination with the Internal Affairs Service of Batangas, as mentioned by the RD, we have filed, or the PIAs have already served subpoena to them to answer the charges of neglect of duty for the chief of police for failure to supervise and control the acts of his men, and irregularity in the performance of the official duty, as they allege that it was a bypass operation, but based on the scrutiny of the documents submitted, so wala, sir, walang regularity, puro irregular. And also, sir, dishonesty for not declaring properly or truthfully the facts of the case, particularly the real place of incident. So this is a continuing effort, sir, and we will not, as instructed by RD, sir, we will not tolerate any wrongdoing, sir, and we will exact high standard of accountability at all levels of command, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. So, the higher authorities of the Philippine National Police in Region 4A know for a fact that the incident happened not within the jurisdiction of the San Juan Police Force na sila ang involved doon sa alleged encounter. In other words, sinasabi po niyo sa amin, nag-operate po sila sa jurisdiction na hindi kanila.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Now, Mr. Chair, may I know if we have invited the medical legal officer of the Batangas police unit, police command? Naimbita ba? Comsec? Yung a certain police major Pitsi Malinaw, the medical legal officer of the Batangas PPO, who conducted the autopsy to the cadaver of the suspect. Andito ba siya? Wala. Now, may I know also if the SOCO, led by Police Senior Master Sergeant Joel Barcelona, is also present? Wala rin. Mr. Chair, may I move that we invite Police Major Pitsi Malinaw and Police Senior Master Sergeant Joel Barcelona in the next hearing para to shed light kung ano po talaga ang nangyari doon sa area na yon.
Sorry, Congressman Acop. There's a motion by Congressman Acop to invite the medical legal. Oh yes, because the SOCO have conducted the also the autopsy.
Yes.
The, okay. The medical so legal. All those the query of Congressman Acop, the COMSEC is hereby directed to secure all those documents and invite those people who had been mentioned by Congressman Acop.
Thank you.
It's ordered.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. May I know who is the who was the team leader of that operation?
Police Master Sergeant Juan Amparo Macaraeg, Your Honor.
Master Sergeant, did you follow or alam mo ba yung manual ninyo sa illegal drug operations?
Yes, Your Honor.
And may I know how many faces are there? If you know. Kasi kung hindi mo masagot yun, basic yun na dapat tatlong faces yung operations na ganito.
5, Your Honor.
5? May, could you please enumerate the 5?
Planning po, coordination, surveillance.
Hindi mo alam. Sasagot mo palang, iho, hindi mo alam.
I'm sorry, Your
Honor. Alam mo, hindi ako magtatanong ng tanong na hindi ko alam yung sagot normally.
I'm sorry, Your Honor.
Ha? Huwag kang magsasabi ng alam mo kung hindi mo alam. Kasi kung nagsisinungaling ka sa maliit na bagay, magsisinungaling ka na sa malalaking bagay, alam mo ba yung ibig kong sabihin? Tinitesting ko lang kung magsasalita ka ng totoo, iho. Di ba? Tinanong ko lang kung alam mo yung proseso ng anti-illegal drug operations. Sabi mo, alam mo. Pero sa unang tanong ko pa lang, bagsak ka na. There are 3 phases, iho. Yung prior to bypass operation, the bypass operation itself, and the post-operation. Maski tanungin mo yung mga opisyal na nakakaalam nito. Ang tanong ko sa iyo, nasunod mo ba lahat to?
Yes, Your Honor.
Paano mo masusunod yung hindi mo alam? Hindi mo nga alam eh, paano mo masusunod? Niloloko mo yata ako.
Nagkaroon, sir, kami
hindi mo nga alam yung proseso eh. Tapos sasabihin mo sa akin, sinusunod mo? Master Sergeant, niloloko mo na ako niyan eh. Di ba? Paano mo susundin o susunod sa isang bagay na hindi mo alam. Kindly explain it to me.
I'm sorry po, Your Honor.
No.
I'm sorry po, Your Honor.
Oh. Sinabihan na kita ng una, huwag mo akong bulahin. Kasi, mas matagal ako sa pulis kaysa sa iyo eh. Eyo. Now, may I go to Madam Michi? Kayo po ba ang bumaril kay Brian?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. Bakit mo siya binaril?
Dahil binaril niya din ako, Sir, Your Honor.
Ano?
Binaril niya din po ako, Sir.
Ah, ibig mo sabihin siya ang unang bumaril?
Yes, Your Honor.
Ibig sabihin, kung nakikinig ako sa pagsasagot mo kanina, dalawang beses siyang pumutok. Di po ba? Tama?
Yes, Your Honor.
So, magkasunod na putok yung pinutok sa iyo?
Yes po, Your Honor.
At a distance of 5 meters, yun ang sinasabi mo kanina?
More or less, Your Honor.
More or less, sige. So, ang ibig sabihin, hindi asintado si Brian, ikaw asintado dahil sinabi mo kanina, isang putok ka lang, pinatamaan mo sa paa para ma-disable siya. Tama po ba?
Yes, Your Honor.
Tama. Napakagaling mo, Iha. May I know what kind of firearm you have?
Sir, yung issued firearm po, Glock 17.9mm, sir.
Glock?
Glock 17, sir.
Glock 17? 9mm? Ha?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes. How many times do you practice shooting that firearm?
Sir, kakatapos ko lang, sir, mag...
Hindi yun ang tanong ko. Hindi ko tinatanong sa iyo, Iha, kung kailan. Ang tinatanong ko, ilang beses kang nagpa-practice na magpaputok ng firearm mo na yan?
Madami po. Ano, sir, mga once a month, sir.
Once a month. Kasi, yun ang SOP. Matanong ko nga, Ardi, yun ba yung SOP ninyo na members of the police force will fire their firearms once a month?
No, Your Honor.
Oh, yeah. Kasi alam ko naman na kasi yung mga security ko, Iha, police din eh. Eh sila nire-require ng kanilang opisina na mag-report sa opisina para iputok nila mag-practice na bumaril. Alam ko yun. Kasi for you to be able to make sure na tamaan mo sa paa ay isang tao, hindi po ako naniniwala dahil shooter din ako, Iha, eh. Hindi mo ako mapaniwala dun. Na putukan ka ng dalawang beses, kaya mo pang putukan sa paa, precisely on the leg, yung biktima. Diba? Kasi sinabi mo, una siyang pumutok eh. Ang unang instinct ng tao ay mag-cover at pumutok. Kaya Iha, sa mga statement mo, hindi mo ako mapaniwala. So, Mr. Chair, I think the investigation conducted by the provincial director of the province of Bulacan ay medyo kompleto.
Batangas.
Yes. Ay kompleto. Tinignan niya lahat yung mga violations na kuan eh na ginawa nung team na nag-operate.
And we have to commend the provincial director and the Batangas and also regional director General Lucas for a job well done. Sige, go ahead.
Ang pinakamasaklap nito eh, bakit sila nag-operate doon sa hindi nila jurisdiction?
Exactly.
And the mayor, I think the statement or the investigation of the provincial director of Batangas is that inireport pa nila na dun sa Batangas, San Juan, Batangas, nangyari. Doon pa lang sa mga report nila, Mr. Chair, ay talagang binibitin na nila yung mga sarili nila eh. My interpellation will continue
Yes.
In the next hearing, Mr. Chair. Thank you very much.
Maraming salamat po, Chairman Acop. No? Before we proceed and before I recognize Congressman Paduano, the Chair would like to acknowledge the presence of Congressman Bienvenido Abante. Meron kaming susunod na hearing dito. Yung aming pong excess deaths. Kaya siguro, 5 minutes na lang po tayo. But we will be inviting over again all these people who are involved. Ang tanong ko lamang kasi, dito sa apidabit nung si Adrian Dimalig Laresma, ano, ay na matapos na mabaril ang aking kapatid na si Brian ay hinila ng mga operatiba na sakay sa pulang kotse upang ipasok sa loob ng nasabing sasakyan. Na pagkapasok ng aking kapatid na nasabing sasakyan ay pilit akong pinaalis ng mga operatiba sa lugar ng pinangyarihan ng insidente at dahil sa takot ako'y umalis na at patungo sa dikalayuan ng insidente doon sa Barangay del Rosario, Chaong. So nangyari sa Chaong, so hinila niyo yung katawan ng tao, isinakay niyo sa sasakyan, inilipat niyo na San Juan para hindi na kayo magko-coordinate doon sa Chaong Municipal Station. Is this correct assumption? Makaraig?
No, Your Honor.
So mali ako. Mali kami sa mga binabasa namin ngayon, ng mga pidabit lahat and even the report of the Provincial Director and Regional Director. Mali kami lahat. Kayo tama. Ganun ba yun?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. So kami nagsisinungaling, hindi kayo nagsisinungaling. Makaraig. So nagsisinungaling kami mga members of this committee. Can you reply to me directly? Nagsisinungaling kami?
No, Your Honor.
Oh. So hindi kami nagsisinungaling. So tama kami. Makaraig. So tama kami. Kayo mali. Okay, so I will not be laboring on that issue anymore. I just wanted to clarify on this hearing that the reason why we put back this resolution of Congressman Acop is dumadami na naman po report ng bypass operation sa amin. So before we end, last word from Congressman...
Series of question.
nakakaya na yung ano eh, yung susunod na ano. And we will be tackling also the issue of sige, Congressman Paduano.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. RD, tsaka PD. May paraffin result ba? Nakunan ba ng paraffin result yung ano?
Sir, mayroon na po.
Mayroon. So, anong resulta ng paraffin result?
Negative po pareho, Your Honor.
Negative pareho. O di, ayun. Napakagaling mong bumaril. Binaril ka. Peres ba? Peres. Pero nung lumabas yung paraffin result, paraffin test, negative. O saan ngayon ang pagpuputok ng biktima? O ito pa. Sabi mo kanina, 5 meters. 5 meters ha? 5 meters. Mr. Laresma. Sino bang unang dumating, ikaw o yung kapatid mo sa lugar?
Una po yung kapatid ko po.
Okay. Pagdating ang naunang kapatid mo, so pagdating mo nandoon yung kapatid mo.
Opo.
Okay. Pagdating mo nandoon na ba yung mga pulis?
Halos sabay-sabay po kami, dalawang kotse po sila eh. Parang kanina.
Halos sabay.
Opo.
Okay. So si Perez kanina is claiming na may nangyaring bypass. Yes. Ano ba nakita mo? Yes. Nag-usap muna sila ni Perez o?
Wala po akong nakita po. Sabay-sabay po kami dumating. Tapos po, bigla po siyang bumaba ng kotse. Sabay binaril na po yung kapatid ko.
Kotse, hindi motor.
Hindi po. Wala po akong nakitang motor kundi po yung sa akin tsaka yung sa kapatid ko.
Oh, wala po lang motor. Kotse daw.
Dalawang kotse po sila.
Perez. Sabi mo kanina may motor ka. Perez, tinatanong kita.
Yes, Your Honor.
Excuse, Mr. Chairman, may I ask that lady? At your back.
Yes, good afternoon, Your Honor. Good
afternoon, Your Honor. Yes, Congressman Paduano, what about that lady?
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, sir, Your Honor.
Good afternoon, Chairperson, and to the members. I approached the Secretariat a while ago and introduced my name. I am Attorney Rotsi Laurino Bermejo, and I will tell them that I will be sitting at the back, sir. So I'm just asking Michi to answer you, sir, because apparently...
No, but you cannot coach. You know...
I didn't coach, sir. I didn't.
Oh, why you are telling them her to answer me?
I asked her to...
What is your personality in this hearing?
Oh, I just asked her to answer you.
No, I ask you, what is your personality in this hearing?
I don't have, sir. That's why I asked permission. Yes, sir.
So you don't have business here?
I assist the San Juan Police Station.
No, you assist? You're the council?
Yes, sir, I assist.
Oh, you should present yourself to this committee, not hiding at the back. Second, let me remind you, attorney, if the chairman will not allow you to give advices to your clients, you cannot.
Yes, sir. I understand, sir.
You understand, but you never tell us that you go.
I went.
No,
to the
in this committee, not in the secretariat.
Oh, I'm sorry about that, sir.
Were you invited by this committee to be present on today's hearing?
No, sir. I was not.
Why are you here? Who invited you over?
The San Juan Police Station, sir.
No.
Who hired you to be a part of their team?
It was the police station of San Juan.
Police station, because the police station is being represented by the new chief of police.
Sir, hindi siya. Sterlingan and the rest.
So you were hired by Colonel Tai Layag to be his personal counsel.
Yes, sir. I was requested to be chair.
But you did not inform the committee or the COMSEC about your presence on today's hearing.
I informed the secretariat a while ago, sir.
Who among us?
Over there.
Na-inform ba kaya?
I am so sorry, but I informed them a while ago. Ma'am. Yes, sir. Sorry.
Okay, but nevertheless, please, if you whisper or say something on those invited reserve speakers, you ask the permission of the chair.
I
otherwise, in the next time, we will putting you outside of this committee hearing. Okay? Go ahead.
I understand perfectly, Your Honor.
Thank you. Thank you, attorney.
Thank you, sir. Sorry.
Perez, ayun. Tugutin mo yung tanong ko.
Yes, sir.
Oh, anong yes, sir?
May motor, sir.
May motor? Now you still stand na may motor?
Yes, sir.
Kanino motor yun?
Sa Alpa, sir.
Sa Alpa mo. And you will not tell this committee your Alpa?
Sir?
You will not tell this committee who is your Alpa. Tama?
Yes, sir. I can't
tell,
sir.
Pupunta natin yan sa next hearing. Kasi tatagal tayo dyan. Anyway, ganito. Sa statement mo kanina, sabi mo, na-consummate yung bypass. Tama?
Yes, sir, Honor. Yes po.
Okay. So, nagbigayan.
Yes, sir.
Mag money item. Tama? O ba't pinatukan mo yung subject?
Sir, mas nauna niya po akong pinatukan.
Hindi nga, tanong nga, ba't puputukan ka ng subject? Nakonsumate yung bypass eh. Kung nagdududa sa'yo, yung subject nyo, dapat hindi nakonsumate yung bypass, nagkabarila na. Di ba? And, alam mo, Perez, hindi ako investigador, si chairman ako pa investigador, pero nakakaintindi rin ako konti sa investigasyon. Tsaka, chairman, tingnan mo, sinasabi niya kanina, mas mabuti sana sinabi mo na hindi na-consummate. Kasi kung na-consummate, walang reason na paputukan ka ng subject. Second, kung na-consummate yung bypass, hindi kayo magkalayo nun. At saka nagkaputukan. Kasi, paano makonsumate ang isang bagay kung 5 meters yung distance nyo? Magbibigayan ba kayo in 5 meters? O ilagay mo dyan yung pera, ilagay ko dito yung items. Ganun ba? Hindi. In short, kung na-consumate yung transaction, kadikit mo yun. At the very least, yung distance nyo is only 1 meter. Not 5 meters. Congressman Paduano, if I may. Medyo late na po tayo sa susunod na issue. I promise you.
Last lang, Chairman. Ito, yes. Manifestation
the
lang.
Next hearing, you will be the first to ask questions.
Manifestation lang, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, go ahead.
Hindi ako magtatanong. Anyway, Perez, sa mga pulis, alam nyo, hindi pa tayo tapos. No? In the next hearing, baka madagdag kayo dyan. Tsaka alam ni RD yung record ko, ha? As a private citizen, as a congressman, alam ni RD kung paano ko sumuporta sa pulis. Pag tama kayo, titindigan kayo dito sa Congress. Pero pag mali kayo, pasensyaan tayo dito. Sa ngayon pa lang, alam ko nagsisinungaling ka, Perez. And I have to ask again, yung mga kasamaan mo dyan, pati yung investigador nyo. Kasi lima lang naman kayo, di ba? Nag-operate?
Yes,
tama?
Sir. Yes, Your Honor.
Hey, Chairman. Okay. I will reserve my question.
Yes,
okay.
Thank you so much, Congressman Paduano. And let this be a reminder to all our members of the organization. Medyo mabigat po itong ating mga kinalalagyan. Nakakaawa po yung mga matitinong mga pulis. Nadadamay po sila. But we have to do this. We have to do this to cleanse the structure of our PNP. Last na tanong ko na to bago tapusin. Kasi kanina, nalaman natin, 7 PM lang dumating yung ano, yung PDEA report. Tapos 6:45, nag-operate na kayo. No firearm, no, na nakalagay sa initial report yung .38 caliber. Wala. Tapos no coordination with the Chaong Police Station. So, have you done this on your own? I know, Colonel, ano, wala ka doon, no? Wala ka doon, no? Wala ka sa area, di ba?
After the operation po ako dumating.
Saka ka dumating. Si ano? Si Makaraig, may nag-utos ba sa inyo para patayin yung taong yun?
Wala po, Your Honor.
Wala? Talagang hindi nyo sinetap to?
Hindi po, Your Honor.
Oh, sige, magkikita tayo sa susunod na hearing. Ano? Unfortunately, we have to wrap up with this hearing and we will be scheduling this on the next hearing siguro. So, for the meantime, I'll be asking Congressman Acop to have a...
Mr. Chair?
Yes?
Before we proceed to the next agenda this afternoon, I think there's a pending issue insofar as the detention of Colonel Reyes is concerned.
Reyes, yes, correct.
May I move that Mr. Our Colonel Reyes detention be lifted after serving 15 days.
Okay.
Pursuant to his motion for reconsideration.
Yes.
So move, Mr. Chair.
So there's a motion that Colonel Reyes' detention in this facility be reduced from 30 days to 15 days. There's a motion and this needs a second motion. Any objection? Hearing none, the said motion is now approved. So, we will be issuing an order of release for Colonel Reyes. And the Sergeant of Arms, who is here right now, is being ordered to facilitate the custody of the 8 PNP officers who have been cited in contempt. So, ordered. Okay, so we'll be suspending this hearing momentarily and we'll be asking all those who are not involved on this issue can go home and the other resource speakers who have been invited for the next item is invited to sit down. Hearing suspended.